Most temperature sensors come with a couple feet of lead wire. But what if you want to extend that distance? Well, you can get accurate readings from three-wire RTD sensors out to about 300 feet using copper wire. But you'll probably want to use three-wire RTD extension cables that are designed expressly for this purpose. Thermocouples can be extended only to around 100 feet, but you have to use the special thermocouple wire that matches the sensor type you're using. And you'll also want to make sure to try and avoid using connectors that create extra thermocouple junctions. It's best to use these special thermocouple DIN-rail terminal blocks that clamp the wires together instead of connecting them through a busbar terminal block like this one. That would just create more thermocouple junctions, which would mess up the temperature you're trying to measure, right? The special thermocouple terminal blocks ensure that you have one continuous flow of the thermocouple wire all the way back to the controller, which gives you clean, unbiased temperature measurements. Now, extension cables are great, but what if you need for the sensor to be even farther away from the controller? Or maybe you have an electrically noisy environment that could interfere with the small temperature signals, especially on long wires. Well, then you definitely want to consider using a temperature transmitter. There's all kinds of these transmitters, but at the end of the day, they all do the same thing. They convert the small temperature signals from the probes to 4 to 20 milliamp signals, so you get a solid, reliable signal back at your controller. A properly set up 4 to 20 milliamp loop can be used reliably for thousands of feet, even miles. It all depends on your system setup, of course, but the point is, these temperature transmitters can send reliable temperature data a really long way. There's DIN-rail mounted, standard, and programmable universal transmitters, sensor head mounted, standard, and programmable universal transmitters, integral transmitters that have the transmitter and probe in one unit, M12 transmitters that let you instantly convert an M12 probe output to a 4 to 20 milliamp, and a programmable universal signal conditioner that also happens to do temperature. The standard transmitters are quick and easy. You just plug them in and go. The universal transmitters give you a lot more control. They work with a variety of sensors and have some awesome features that just make your life a whole lot easier. That's a lot to cover in one video, so we'll do the standard transmitters in this video and then learn how to configure the universal transmitters in a separate video. For this video, let's focus on the standard temperature transmitters. The ProSense temperature transmitters service one type of sensor over a specific temperature range. This one's for a type J thermocouple. You plug the thermocouple in here and connect your 4 to 20 milliamp loop here. Easy. Nothing to set or calibrate. There's another one for type K, another one for type T, and one for RTD sensors. You get the idea. You order a separate transmitter for each type of sensor. You also need to specify a fixed temperature range for these ProSense transmitters. You have a number of temperature range options to choose from for each sensor type. Why? Well, to give you better resolution. If you choose a 0 to 2000 degree Fahrenheit transmitter, which sends 4 milliamps here and 20 milliamps here to the controller, but your temperatures are only in a 0 to 200 degree range, then you'll only ever see this much of the 4 to 20 milliamp range. But if you choose the 0 to 200 degree transmitter, now 20 milliamps is at 200 degrees, so you get the benefit of the full 4 to 20 milliamp range, which means you get much more accurate results. So be sure you choose the transmitter that best suits your temperature range if resolution is important to you. The blue temperature transmitters from Fax Engineering do the exact same thing. But you have a few more options with these. The one thermocouple unit works for all the same thermocouple probes as the ProSense units and several more, but you don't need a separate transmitter for each probe. You just select the probe type using dip switches. It also operates as a millivolt to milliamp converter, so you can use any small voltage source you want instead of a probe. The ProSense transmitters work from 12 to 35 volts. The blue transmitters only work at 24 volts. If you have a known calibrated input, you can adjust the zero and the span of the output of the blue transmitter to optimize your system. For some special applications, that can be important. Most of the time, you probably won't need that. Both units send a large or upscale current on fault, like if the thermocouple burns out or shorts. But only the blue unit allows you to set that to a low or downscale current value. The yellow LED on the front of the ProSense unit indicates power. The LED on the front of the blue thermocouple transmitter is green for running, but red during power-up and if there's an internal calibration error or a thermocouple burnout condition. That's really handy to be able to see if there's a fault indication right on the front of the box. The blue transmitter has a burnout detection disable. That is, it doesn't allow the current to go beyond the 4 to 20 milliamp range. That's in case you have a calibration unit that can't handle the overcurrent condition. You also need to disable the burnout function if you're applying millivolts to the input instead of a probe. Both units have internal cold junction temperature compensation, but only the blue unit has a disable. You would use this if you want to do your own compensation, or if you're using this as a millivolt to milliamp converter. The blue transmitters don't allow you to choose optimized temperature ranges like the ProSense transmitters, which means if you select a J-type thermocouple on the blue unit, the 4 to 20 milliamps will be spread across the full J thermocouple range, whether you need it or not. Of course, for most applications, that really isn't an issue, especially since thermocouples are spec'd to plus or minus several degrees anyway. So if you need any of these special features, then definitely consider the blue thermocouple transmitter from Facts Engineering. Otherwise, the economical ProSense transmitter is very capable and it'll work great in a majority of your applications. As a side note, the programmable ProSense transmitters that we cover in the next video do just about everything these blue transmitters do and a lot more. But you have to purchase a special programming cable to use them. Check out part 2 of this video for more on those. The RTD transmitters have a similar comparison, with the only real differences being the ProSense transmitters only handle PT100 RTDs, the blue transmitters work for several types of RTDs, again switch selectable. And the ProSense RTD transmitters offer several temperature ranges, just like the thermocouple units, but the blue Facts Engineering unit only covers the entire RTD range. Both the thermocouple and RTD ProSense transmitters are available in a sensor head mounted version. You just swap out the terminal block for the transmitter and you're done. Let's do a live demo using the ProSense DynRail thermocouple transmitter. We have a J-type thermocouple probe, so we'll select a J-type transmitter, and we want to use it over a 0 to 200 degree temperature range, so we select the 0 to 200 degree J-type transmitter. Attach a thermocouple here and a 4 to 20 milliamp loop here. We'll apply power to the loop, and normally your controller would go here. For this demo, we're going to bypass the controller and simply put a current meter here so we can see what's going on. Power it up, and for the first few seconds, we see we get an undercurrent of something well below the bottom 4 milliamps. That's a signal to the controller that the transmitter is powering up and calibrating. Once that's done, we're ready to read the temperature. Looks like we're at 10.3-ish milliamps, which if you do the math, comes out to a warm room temperature of about 79 degrees. Perfect. If we drop the sensor in a cup of ice water, it takes the thermocouple a couple seconds to respond to the temperature change because it takes time for the temperature change to get through the metal mounting block and reach the actual probe. Looks like it's going to settle out at around 6.7 milliamps, which if we do the math, is about 34 degrees F, pretty much exactly what we would expect in an ice water bath. Now if we move the probe to a cup of hot water, again, it takes a couple seconds to respond. By the way, this probe isn't really intended for immersion, of course. It's just one I happen to have laying around, and it works fine for this little demo. Looks like we're going to settle out at around 17 milliamps, which is 162 degrees F. The integral temperature transmitters come in several temperature ranges and with quarter-inch MBT threads, so you can screw them right into the process tank, or with a straight shaft that you would insert into a compression fitting. These integral sensors are really handy because it's everything you need in one package. But they don't have as many temperature range offerings, and of course they're only available as RTD sensors. The M12 transmitter is for 3 and 4 wire RTD probes. You just plug it onto the probe and you instantly have a 4 to 20 milliamp temperature transmitter that'll work with any M12 4-pin cable. You can also use an M12 extension cable between the sensor and the transmitter. Just like the other guys, you have to specify the fixed temperature range that you want to use. And of course, you would take the other end of the copper wires that used to go to an RTD module on the controller and instead run them into a 4 to 20 milliamp analog input card. Bottom line here is, given the probe type, the temperature range, and the form factor, selecting and using a temperature transmitter is easy. If you need any help, please don't hesitate to contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support. They'll be happy to help you. And don't forget the forums. There are a lot of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any support questions there. The forums aren't monitored on a regular basis by Automation Direct's support staff.